Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial on taking objects from Photoshop to use them in Illustrator. In this video tutorial, I'll be using a couple of elements from Design Cuts collections, so let's go and have a look and see what I'm going to be using. I'm going to be using a picture corner from the picture corner vector and brush pack, and I'm going to be using a texture from this very wonderful Ultimate Texture and Photography kit. So let's head back to Photoshop. Here I have an image of a flower and it's got a texture over the top, so you can see that I've got two layers here that are interacting with each other. I can take this to Illustrator in one of a number of ways. One way I can do this is just to choose Select All in Photoshop, and then I'll need to choose Edit and then Copy Merged. You'll need to use Copy Merge when you're working with a multi-layered document in Photoshop, otherwise you won't be copying the whole of the document. So I'll just click Copy Merged. I'll go across to Illustrator where I have a new empty document already created, and I'll choose Edit and then Paste. At this point, I could resize the object by holding the Shift key as I drag on one of the corner handles. But let's have a look in the Layers palette and see what we brought in here. Well, we brought in a flattened image. Everything is in a single image layer, so we've lost the layers that we had in Photoshop. So let's have a look at another way of bringing this particular image into Illustrator, but maintaining the layers. If that's important to you, this is how you do it. I'll choose File and then Open. And I've got this image here as a layered PSD file, a Photoshop format file. So all I'll do is select it and then click Open. And at this point, I'm given the option to convert the layers to objects, which I'm going to select, but I could also flatten the layers to a single image. Well, that's what we got here, and we decided that we wanted a different option this time. So I'm going to choose Convert Layers to Objects, and I'll just click OK. So this time I have a new file in Illustrator. The artboard is exactly the same size as the image, and here I have two layers. One layer has the background image, the original flower, and the other layer here has the overlay image. So if it's important to you to bring layers into Illustrator, it's best to save the file out of Photoshop as a layered PSD file and then just open it in Illustrator. Let's head back to Photoshop where I have another image open. Now this is one of the photo corners, and clearly this is a transparent image. It's got transparency in the background. Well, I'll choose Select All, and I'm going to choose Edit and then Copy. Don't have to choose Copy Merge because this is just a single layer file. Let's go back to Illustrator and have a new document just sitting here. Let's choose Edit and then Paste. Well, it looks like this has worked just perfectly. We've got our photo corner here in Illustrator, but look what happens when I drag it off the edge of the artboard. You'll see that the transparency has been lost. Transparency isn't maintained when you bring an object from Photoshop into Illustrator. So I'm just going to delete that, and let's have a look and see what we would do if transparency were important to us. Well, in this case, we'd start inside Illustrator. We'll create a new document and then we'll choose File and then Place. And now we'll go to our ping image, or our image that has transparency in it, and click Place. And now I'll simply drag out an area for the image to be placed into this Illustrator file. This time you'll see that the transparency is in the file. Now you could bring this in as a link, or you could bring it in as an embedded object. But if you want the transparency, then don't go direct from Photoshop to Illustrator. Instead, save the file out with its transparency and then bring it into Illustrator as a file place. Let's head back to Photoshop for a minute and have a look at another type of object that you may want to take from Photoshop to Illustrator, and that is a custom shape. In Photoshop, there are heaps and heaps of custom shapes available. These aren't available in Illustrator. So you may want to take a custom shape that you have here in Photoshop, and you may want to use it in Illustrator. So here's how to do it. I'm going to grab one of these floral shapes that comes with Photoshop, but you could do this with shapes that come with Photoshop or ones that you download from the web. There are heaps of them available for Photoshop. There are precious few available for Illustrator. I'm going to make sure that I'm working with path here because I just want the path, and I'll hold the Shift key as I drag my shape out because I want this to be scaled in proportion. Once I've got it in as a path in Photoshop, all I'll do is choose Edit and then Copy, and then I'll swing across to Illustrator and choose Edit and then Paste. I'll be asked if I want to bring in a compound shape or a compound path. I want mine to be fully editable, so I'm just going to click OK. And now we have a compound shape here in Illustrator. It has no fill and no stroke. So if we want to see it, we're going to have to fill it with something. So I'm just going to apply a sort of blue fill to it. This is a nice and easy way to harness the power of the shape collection that you have in Photoshop, but use it in Illustrator. One final element that you may have in Photoshop and want to use in Illustrator is a pattern piece. Just going to remove this shape. Let's head back to Photoshop. I'm also going to get rid of this shape here. Now to find your pattern piece, you're going to choose Edit and then Fill, and you'll go to Pattern, and you're going to drop down the custom pattern list. And what you need to do is to just hover your mouse over the pattern piece that you want to take to Illustrator. Now I have a little leaves pattern here that I made in an earlier video tutorial, and it's 1,000 pixels by 1,000 pixels. When I just hover my mouse over it here in the pattern palette, I can read how big it is. And that's all we came here to do. So I'm just going to cancel out of this dialog, and I'm going to create a brand new document or resize this document. It doesn't really matter. And I'm going to create one that is the exact same size as my pattern piece. And mine is 1,000 by 1,000. Yours may differ in size. Now we'll choose Edit and then Fill. We'll go to Pattern. We'll choose Custom Pattern, and we'll just click OK. Because this is the pattern swatch that is stored in Photoshop, and this will make a seamlessly repeating pattern when it's used either in Photoshop or in Illustrator. So I'm going to choose Select All, and I'm going to choose Edit Copy. I'm going to switch to Illustrator, and I'll choose Edit Paste. This is our pattern swatch here in Illustrator, and we can just drag and drop it into the swatches panel, and it will become a pattern swatch that we can use here. Now there is a proviso for this. It's not possible to easily alter the coloring for your pattern swatch. So if you want to alter the color, it's best to do that in Photoshop before you leave Photoshop. But let's just go and create a rectangle here, the size of this artboard. The fill is at the 4, and let's just go and click on our pattern swatch. And you can see here that we have a bitmap repeating pattern in Illustrator. This is not a vector pattern. It's still a bitmap pattern. But you know, if you've got a pattern in Photoshop that you want to use in Illustrator, it is possible to use it. So there are some of your options for working between Photoshop and Illustrator. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below. And give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.